decided to cook me husband on the day you left me. The day you left me, I cried for 16 hours solid. And when I looked in the mirror, me face was all blotchy and I thought, he's done this to you, him. Of course, when your husband leaves you, the word bastard comes into your head in big, bold letters. At first, it just forms silently on your lips. Then you start to mutter it under your breath. Then you whisper it vehemently, spitting out the consonants, and as it drums in your head, so you bang it out, deep and loud, and it builds, till before you know it, you're screaming at the top of your voice! Bastard! When your husband leaves you, you'll know what I mean. There's bastard now. Bang on time, as usual. The best thing I can say about him after 19 years of marriage is that he's punctual. She's coming in. It! They've come together for dinner. I suppose I better let them in. No, they can wait.
So you're not hungry then?
Of course we are. Starving.
Oh, well, I hope so. There's enough to feed the 5,000.
Oh, well, smells good, Hillary.
The proof of the pudding is in the eating.
I'm on a diet.
She doesn't need a diet, does she, Ken?
No, she's beautiful as it is.
Oh, how lucky you are to have a husband who adores you no matter what you look like.
I have an offer to a drink. What will it be, Ken?
The usual, white wine, please.
And you, what's your poison?
I'll have what Ken has.
How lovely we're all having the same. There's a bottle cooling in the kitchen. Won't be a sec.
Lorraine.
Laura.
Whatever.
Did we have to come tonight? I'm not in the mood for it, Ken.
Just keep smiling, Laura. Everything will be all right.
Everything all right? I'm getting face ache, Ken.
Relax then, just be yourself.
I can't be myself, she doesn't like me.
Of course she does.
See the way she's staring at me?
You're imagining things.
I feel sick.
You'll be all right.
I will not be all right, it's not right coming here, it's not normal.
She's only trying to be friendly, will you stop overreacting, making a big deal out of everything?
I don't make a big deal out of everything, we should never have come, it's your fault, why can't you say no
but
to
her? For God's sake, Laura, shut up!
What's this? A lover's tip. Kenneth and I used to have them all the time, didn't we, Kenneth? When we were lovers. Is she always so miserable, Kenneth? So sulky?
Just a bit tired, that's all. She's been looking forward to coming up. Needs a bit of cheering up.
Really, she doesn't seem to be making much effort. If I didn't know better, I'd say she didn't want to be here.
No, no, she... We're both thrilled you invited us. It's nice to behave in a civilised way, you know.
Yes, after the way you treated me. Still, I hope your wife feels the same. I wouldn't want to be the cause of any rift.
No, no, everything's under control.
You're looking well. Isn't Hillary looking well, Laura?
Yeah. Thank you, that's very nice. Oh, I always think when people say I look well, they mean fat.
No.
Yeah. Oh, well, I'm famished, and I'd rather enjoy my food than my figure. Oh, come on, Sulky. Cheer up!
What does she mean, cheer up? What does she expect? What were you whispering about, anyway?
When?
Just then, you were talking about me.
Don't start getting paranoid, Laura. Hillary was only making a little joke.
Well, there's no need to whisper unless you were joking about me.
No, you don't know the person. It's someone we used to know.
Oh, great. I didn't know you were going to discuss old times.
Shut up! So, Hillary, what are we having for dinner? Smells delicious.
Oh, a very special dish, Kenneth. A surprise. That's what we're having for dinner. A surprise.
eyes.
Well, knowing you, it'll be extremely palatable.
I hope so.
You do both eat meat?
Yes.
Oh, excellent. I couldn't bear it if you were both vegetarians. I didn't think to ask, Kenneth. I assumed you hadn't changed a taste in food.
Only women.
She's staring at me again, Kenneth.
Don't be ridiculous. At least try and make an effort. She's been through a lot, you know.
And I haven't.
Not now, Laura.
Why tonight? She knows it's special. Why invite us round tonight and you have to say yes?
I love to celebrate. Any old reason will do for a little celebration. How long has it been?
3 years.
3 years? My. 3 years and you're still together. Well done, both of you. How long did we last, Kenneth?
19.
Oh, is that all? Still, 3 years. You must be very pleased.
Fucking thrilled.
I'm sorry, Hilary.
Don't apologise. Just let her be herself. A toast to the happy couple on their third wedding anniversary, Kenneth and Laura. Cheers.
She's so good at it, making me feel unwelcome and uncomfortable, and I'm supposed to feel grateful because she's serving up dinner in our honour. See the way she looks at it? Like she's hungry for him after all these years, licking her lips, salivating. And see the way she stares at me, smiling sweetly, but behind those eyes, wicked thoughts. Look at them laughing together. Anyone would think they were still married. Anyone would think it was their anniversary, their celebration. I should have brought them a present.
Cigarette? I'll have one.
You don't smoke.
So I can have a cigarette if I want one.
Oh dear, is she being a bit of a baby?
No, she isn't. She just fancies a smoke.
Oh, well. I've cigars, if you'd rather.
Or a pipe. That doesn't surprise me. I can just see you with a pipe stuck in your gut.
Now, Laura, we don't want any arguments.
Nobody's arguing, Ken. Just keep your nose out.
Can I help at all, Hilary?
Oh, not just now, Kenneth. Everything's going according to plan.
What is it you were going to do, Ken?
What?
How were you going to help?
Well, I don't know. That'll be up to Hilary, of course.
But you've never been in a kitchen before. How could you possibly help her?
Well, as long as you steer clear of it, we should all be safe from salmonella.
Ken doesn't like my cooking, Hilary, but he's always spoken very highly of yours.
Oh, well, that's nice. We have to be appreciated for something.
Yes, yeah. We do. And don't think I don't know what her game is. Bringing him here, tempting him back with her fine food, showing me up for a fool. Well, I hope it burns and she serves up ashes. I hope it's souffle and it flops with a fart. Maybe I could sneak in there and turn up the oven. Or better still, just turn it off. So when she thinks it must be done, whatever it is uncooked and cold. Still frozen in the middle, she'll have to send off for a takeaway. And how disappointed he would be. So badly let down. I tried to stuff his face before we came so he wouldn't have an appetite, but he sacrificed mine for his. Well, the fat pig might just regret it if there is no dinner at all. Besides, he only has to taste her trifle, sniff her soup, swallow her salmon mousse, and he'll be in raptures. Seventh heaven. I won't allow it. I won't tolerate it. I will not let him touch her food.
Peanut, anyone? Tom? Perhaps I ought to put on a record. Any requests? As if I didn't know what you'd have on, Kenneth.
He's grown out of Elvis, if that's what you mean.
Oh, surely not. You haven't. Have you?
You don't grow out of Elvis, Laura. You grow into him. I'm afraid she doesn't appreciate the finer characteristics in Presley's songs, though I've played them to her over and over again in the hope of persuading her of his genius. There's none so deaf as those that will not hear.
You don't know what you're missing, Laura. Partying was Kenneth's middle name. When he danced, the floor shook and the records jumped. When he cracked a joke, he laughed louder than anyone else. And when he'd had one too many, we all ran for cover. His all-time hero was the king himself, Elvis Aaron Presley, and he never let anyone forget that. Not Kenneth. My. Oh.
Colorado.
He goes by the name of King Creole. You know he's gone, gone, gone. Jumping like cabbage on a pole.
So there I was, doing 120 in the Saab, when this blue bottle overtakes us. No siren flashing and nothing, I'm thinking bloody cheap. Laws for them are different to laws for us, know what I mean? So I put my foot down, didn't I? And me and this copper are churning down the M6, neck and neck, doing 150, and before he can pull me over, his tyre blew out. Pass us another beer, mate, will you? Roll this bottle of brandy with us. Blow your head off, it will. Absolutely beautiful. It's on the table over there. Go and try it, Mickey. Go on, you won't get your breath. I'm telling you. Unbelievable. 28 quid a bottle. Is the food coming out yet? I'm starving. Nice little chili wouldn't go amiss, know what I mean? I'm sick of the cider sandwiches. We had this meal the other day. Absolutely beautiful little place. They gave us a leg of lamb this big. It was unbelievable. That's the sort of portion you should get. These restaurants haven't got a clue. It's a little bit of this and a little bit of that. Wouldn't feed an insect. Did you try it, Mickey? What did you think? Look at his face. He's gone bright red. Ha! What did I tell you, mate? Take your leg off your shoulders. Mind you, it's beautiful stuff if you drink it slowly. Imported. We brought them back from Spain. Have you been? Beautiful country. Once you get out of the resorts, the countryside goes on for miles. We must have toured out the country, stayed in some cracking little villas. Hillary wasn't pleased. She wanted to stay in Benidorm. But I mean, it's on from home, isn't it? I mean, if you're going to go to these places, you might as well explore them. Mind you, they're mad drivers, them Spanish. I mean, we were on this coach. He must have been doing 120. And they had no time like ours. Don't forget, I mean, it's bumpy, bumpy all the way. Hillary was scared to death, kept saying she was going to be sick. God, wouldn't that be great? Stinker sick for 12 hours in a coach. Blah. Hello, darling. I was just telling him about Spain. Oh. I've been trying the brandy. Ha! Anything to eat yet? Nothing to eat yet. And nobody's dancing. Oh. They haven't got a clue, have they? We'll have to have a party.
Yeah.
Show them how it's done. Hey. I had this restaurant. I was in this restaurant. We had this barbecue the other day. Absolutely beautiful weather. Sunday it was. We had pieces of chicken this big. It was unbelievable.
Hey. Are you on your own?
Yeah.
Oh.
I've known Don and Sal for a few months, but I don't know any of their friends.
No boyfriend.
He couldn't make it, and I'm not stopping in because of some fella.
That's right. You go in there and enjoy yourself, have a dance. I'm Hilary, by the way.
Laura.
Yeah.
Are you with your husband?
No. I'm afraid I am. He's in there somewhere making a bloody fool of himself.
I've been helping Sal with the food if there's not much here. But what there is, we'll be bringing out in a minute. You better start a queue, because my husband will have the lot.
Do you need any help?
And now you're all right, go on, go in.
Thanks,
yeah.
See you later.
One week it's my heart on fire.
It's a short diversion. It won't take a minute. It would be my pleasure. No trouble. Hey, I'd like to. Really? It'd be great.
Just great.
You see, he doesn't mind.
I don't want to impose.
Impose? Oh. Impose? Oh. As if you would. It'll be a treat to have some company in the car. The times I've said to Hillary, what a lonely business
driving is.
I don't mind getting the bus.
Oh, we wouldn't hear of it. Hey, you're not worried about him, are you? Take no notice. He's all talk and he's used to driving pissed. You'll be all right.
I wouldn't dream of letting you slum it. Beautiful woman like you. You deserve to travel home in style.
You've only got a Vauxhall Nova.
So, well, it's better than a bus, isn't it?
And that's the discussion we were having, whether she should go home by car or bus.
I know the discussion you were having, Kenneth. I started it. It was me who asked her if she wanted a lift in the first place, and he left up to who should be walking her.
I mean, you just heard me offer to drive her, didn't you? I mean, you heard me ask her, haven't you?
You know, I can't think why she wanted a lift with such an arrogant pig as you. I'm sure I'd rather take the bloody bus. You're probably frightened her to death the speed you drive, or worse. Have an accident, but go for laying through the windscreen. If I was her, a walk, it's safer.
Yeah, but you're not her. And nobody's asking you, so shut your mouth. You're embarrassing the poor girl.
It's you who's embarrassing yourself, you ridiculous mama. You're dancing and you talk a style. Oh, come on, I want to go home. Ta-ra, Sal. Bubba's coming again. Yeah, keep the brandy, see ya.
You what?
Oh, shut up. Nobody liked it anyway. It was only fit for the plug-o. Hey, hold him up. Let's get off.
You should have let me get the bus. It only caused an argument.
Don't be silly. I've told you we always argue like that.
Ken, I wish you'd tell her.
I will. I will tell her.
Just hang on a little bit longer.
My nerves are on edge. I feel sick all the time.
Anyone would think we were committing a crime.
Be mine.
Morning, Cat.
Morning, Hill.
Want some breakfast?
Bacon and eggs.
Oh, leave us some.
Sure, babe, how much?
Just to get dinner.
What are we having?
Roast like a lamb.
You know the way to me heart.
Have a good day at work.
And you.
See you, bye.
Bye.
Darling, I'm home.
Did you have a good day?
I'm exhausted.
Oh, dinner's nearly ready.
Good, I'm starving.
I've done your favour. It
smells fantastic.
There's a bell on tonight.
Does it look any good?
We can watch it in bed.
Sounds good to me.
Ready to eat.
You know me.
Come and get it.
Morning, Kenneth.
Morning, Elle.
What's the breakfast?
Just a piece of toast.
Can you leave some money?
Sure, babe. How much?
Just to get five.
Is there food in for dinner?
Yeah, spaghetti with meatballs.
Can't wait.
Have a good day at work.
And you, my pet.
See you, bye.
Bye.
2 teaspoonfuls of salt, a sprinkling of garlic, tomatoes, peppers, and meatballs. Pasta and bread.
Darling, I'm home.
Oh, you look tired.
You look great.
Well, take off your shoes.
Something smells nice.
Well, it's not your feet.
What's wrong with my feet?
Have you been running?
Don't be ridiculous. What do you mean?
Don't take it to heart.
Well, give it a rest.
It's what a rest.
Your constant nagging.
It was a joke.
Well, it wasn't funny.
Spaghetti's are nearly ready.
I'm not very hungry.
Morning, Kenneth.
You haven't cooked breakfast.
Did you sleep all right?
What, the sofa's hardly comfortable.
That was your idea.
I'll make it myself.
Oh, it won't take a minute.
Get out of my way.
Please, let me do it.
You know I'll be late.
We'll be ready in a minute.
Some of us have a job to go to.
Oh, see you at 5. We haven't planned dinner. What shall I cook? He's left no money. Oh, fuck. He could phone. He knows how to reverse the charges if you can't get the change. He must have broken down. Bloody car. Bloody hell, where is he? I hope he hasn't had an accident. He has. He's had an accident, and any minute now the blue bottle will be at the door. He's run out of petrol again. I wish he'd fixed that gauge. You never know where you are with a faulty petrol gauge, or maybe I should phone the hospitals just in case. And no, I can't send out a search party for a grown man. He's only 2 hours late from work. Still, he could phone.
Why wouldn't he phone?
Unless he's dead or injured. Maybe he's nowhere near a call box. Broken down on the aero, trying to flag down help him. If anything's up to him, I don't know what I'd do. I didn't say goodbye to him in a very nice voice this morning. I didn't even kiss him. And now I might never see his face again. Oh, God. I'll talk you by my mind. Read a book, watch the telly, I'm being silly, he's perfectly all right. Something and nothing. We'll be laughing about it in an hour. If he's not back by then, I'll call the hospital. Still, I didn't know what I'd say to them. I mean, surely they'd phone me if he was in there. Unless he's got no ID on him. Maybe they're waiting for someone to phone, and maybe he's lying in there, all broken up and... Ooh. I don't think I could stand that. It was best to just sit and wait. Oh, I can't bear to, just in case. I'm being silly. I'll count the cars as they go past the window. And if he's not back by next week, then I'll phone.
A table!
Does she know you're here?
Who?
Hillary, of course.
No, she doesn't know I'm here.
Where are you supposed to be?
I don't know. I haven't thought of anything yet.
Well, why don't you ring her and tell her the truth?
No. She's not interested in where I am. She's too wrapped up in herself. There's no need.
Sir, you can stay the night then.
No, I can't stay the night. I'd love to, but she's selfish like that. She doesn't want me, but she needs anyone else to have me. Yes!
What was she like in bed?
Dog!
Tell me!
Very boring. Very ordinary. Not like you at all. She was only interested in cooking and cleaning.
I can't understand women like that. I'd hate to be tied down to a house. I like to go out, have fun.
That's right. You have no idea what it's been like living with her. It's been like living with me mother.
Well, don't go back there. Stay with me. Phone her. Tell her.
No. I can't phone her. She hates the phone. She never answers it. She's got a phobia about it. A phone phobia. The ringing gives her a headache. It's best if I don't.
Well, how long can you stay?
As soon as I finish here, I'll have to be going.
Oh, Ken, why? She doesn't even care about you, and I need you. Oh, you haven't, have you?
Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
It's not fair. The least you could do is try to make it last.
Sorry, Laura. It's the stress I'm under. I'll make it up to you. Don't worry.
Jesus Christ, where have you been? Oh, my nerves won't stand this. Can't you even put your fingers in the phone and dial? God, I've been worried sick. Where the bloody hell have you been?
Oh, you keep on saying.
What?
That scratch.
Where?
All down your back.
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing?
It's just a scratch.
Well, how did you do it?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No, I must have just scratched myself.
How can you scratch yourself? From the top of your neck down to your backside, it's not possible. You can't do it.
Don't tell me what I can and can't do, all right? If I say I did it myself, I did it myself. You crackers, woman. I used my right hand for the top half. And my left hand for the bottom half. I had an itch. It was an accident. My nails were sharp. You don't spy on me and tell me what I've been doing when you know nothing about it. All right, just stop harassing me. I'm warning you.
Suspicion torments my heart. Suspicion keeps us apart. Suspicion, I try to be.
Yum, 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 yum. Oh, delicious. I'm starving. I could eat a horse. My peaches and cream, milky white skin, candy floss hair, cherry lips, and juicy. Fruity.
Is it that I'm too fat? Is that what it is?
No. Oh. No. Honestly, I'm just very tired. Hmm. You know the overtime I've been putting in lately?
Yeah, I've been wanting to talk to you about that.
What?
Well, if you're doing so much overtime, you must be picking up more money.
Yeah, of course I am.
Well, when are you going to start leaving more, I mean? Hey, what are you doing with it?
I've been putting it in the bank. Save up, take you on holiday maybe, something like that.
Oh, that's nice. I could do with a holiday. Oh, I've been that tired. I know you've been working too hard. It's affecting your nerves.
It is, yeah, it makes me jumpy. Overtime. Right. Well, don't worry. I'll sort something out.
Thank you. I can wear
trousers. We might go for a drink when we finish.
Another car.
Dead right.
Where?
Back to the horseshoe.
Right. I'll see you in there then.
Why? You don't like drinking with me and Bob.
I might if you asked me.
I don't ask you because I know you don't like to.
I'd like to, Tammet.
But we might not go.
You won't need King Clothes then.
But we might.
I'll see you in there then.
We're very spontaneous, me and Bob. If we go, we go. If we don't, we don't. We can't be worrying about what you're doing, Hilary.
How long will it take?
What?
Their work on the car?
I don't know. It might take some time.
What's wrong with it?
The suspension.
The suspension?
Yeah, that's what I said. Now, will you let me get on?
Are you definitely going then?
Yes.
You've arranged it then?
Yes.
Ah, you said you might be going out tonight. You didn't say you definitely arranged it.
Well, definitely, probably. He's expecting me.
What would you say if I said I didn't want you to see Bob tonight?
Then I wouldn't see him.
I don't want you to see Bob tonight.
Why not? What's the matter with you? It's been arranged and I'm seeing him. Why can't I see Bob? He's my friend. Why don't you like him? Why are you trying to cause trouble? He's my mate. I'm seeing Bob, Hilary, whether you like it or not. Good God, can't you understand I need men's company from time to time? Do you have to be so selfish?
I didn't know he was so important to you.
Why do you have to make such a big deal out of everything?
It's not me who's making a big deal out of everything. It's not me who's squirming.
Squirming?
Yeah.
Squirming?
Yeah.
Squirming?
Yeah.
Why would I squirm?
How the hell should I know?
You've got a screw loose, you have. You're losing your mind. Go and get some professional help and don't talk to me until you're well. It's like living with a lunatic. You want to be careful. You want to be careful, I'll have you certified. She knows. She knows. I answered too quickly. The suspension, I said straight off. I should have hesitated. Perhaps if I'd said something more convincing. Like a fan belt. I don't know. Oh, that's it. My life's over. I'm finished. How could I be so stupid? How could she know we've been so discreet? How could I be? I should have told her straight. If you're implying something, Hilary, just come out and say it. I can assure you I've got nothing to hide. I should have made a joke of it. Said she had a warped sense of humour. But how could I? See, she never actually accused me of anything. It was all indirect. Cunning. But she's not like that. Maybe she doesn't know. Maybe I'm getting paranoid. But of course she doesn't know. How could she? Oh! Oh, relief! Oh! It's just my conscience making me think. What if she does know? We'll just have to be extra careful, just in case. Take extra precautions. I've had a bad scare, but there's nothing she can prove, so just calm down. Relax. In the future, be more reassuring to her. Be nicer to her. Buy her some flowers. Women and flowers. The answer to all their fears, that's the sort of stuff she needs. It's best if I tell her. In my own time. Not that I find out. I can't stand the thought of all those screaming hysterics. I'll have to pay her more compliments. Not from the heart, Laura, just from the brain. I can't stand the thought of all those accusing looks and are done by speeches. We'll just have to be very, very secretive. What you don't know can't hurt her. Good, good, I feel better now. What are the things I go through for you? I hope you appreciate it.
I don't like telling lies. I'm not very good at it.
No, no, no. It's not telling lies, exactly. It's more withholding the truth. This is our business. It's nothing to do with her or anybody else. So just keep it closed. It's not forever.
Just until the time is right to tell her.
Well, I think you should tell her now. It's not fair on her, is it?
I can't tell her.
Well, I'll tell her.
No. No. I don't think so, Laura. She's not like you. She's different. You're not it.
Well,
Get her pissed. She'll let it all out if she has a good session. It's not good for your nerves bottling things up.
Finding out I'm having an affair won't do much good for her nerves.
Oh, an affair, am I? I thought it was a bit more important than that.
Whoops. You are. The truth is, she'd kill me.
No, she wouldn't. She loves you.
Hey, why are we talking about her at all? Can't we just be together? Can't we just be together and forget she exists?
I can't see how you're ever going to leave her if she doesn't exist!
I'll tell her when the time is right! Perhaps it'd be best to put the split down to something else.
Like what?
I don't know. Money problems, differences, something that won't make her feel so angry and upset. You can understand that, can't you?
No! If you're going to leave her, she might as well know why. Anyway, I hoped I might be friends with her once it's all finished. I haven't got any girlfriends to have a good natter with.
But she wouldn't... I think you're asking just a teeny-weeny bit much of a lawyer.
You really underestimate the female, Ken. We're strong buggers, you know. Yeah. She'll get over you, don't you worry, and she'll probably need me to help her through it.
How can I put this?
No, no, and no. Just shut your bloody mouth and drop the subject. If I find out you've told a living soul about us, you will be in very big trouble.
Oh, maybe it is me. Maybe I am mental. I don't want to feel this way. Untrusting and suspicious, it feels horrible. But once the idea comes into your head, you've got to know. Oh, I'm sure I'm wrong. I hope I'm wrong. Of course I'm wrong, but just to be sure, I'll plant a hair on his coat. I'll ask him how he got there. Watch his reaction. If he's cool and disinterested, then I've nothing to worry about. But if he's madly defensive, then I think I may have a problem.
Yeah.
No, don't tell me. Laura. Laura, of course it is.
What can I do for you, Laura?
Hey, how do you know where I live?
I've come for a chat.
Oh, I suppose Sal told you it's an open house.
Boyfriend trouble, is it?
Yes! It is, as a matter of fact. I don't really know how to tell you. I know you're going to kill me. I don't blame you. He won't tell you. I've begged him and I've begged him and I can't go on like this.
Tell me what?
Who? Well, you probably already know. I mean, we met at one of Sal's parties. He was there. You couldn't make it.
What dinner couldn't I make? I go to all Sal's. She doesn't have a do if I don't go. Has she sent you about something?
I've come to explain.
Explain what?
Why your husband's been so distant. Where he's been. What he's been up to.
You what?
He's been with me.
Is this a joke, love? Only I've got something burning under the grill. I just thought you ought to know. Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm sorry.
I can't think what you're on about. Look, whatever it is you've come round here to say, just say it and then piss off for busy.
Kenneth and I are lovers. We have been for a long time. He wouldn't tell you, so I have.
I'm sorry.
I had to tell you.
This isn't very funny.
I know it isn't funny. I'm sorry, I had to tell you.
And there's been a mistake. You're mixed up. You're telling lies. Look, I'm going to tell my husband about you when he gets in. He's not going to take it very lightly. If you've got a grudge against him about something, this is not the way to sort it out. Oh, I know you're lonely. On your own. But just because you haven't got a boyfriend doesn't mean to say you can make up stories. Fantasize about other women's husbands. It was a party, wasn't it? You were looking at me jealous because I've got a husband and you haven't.
I honestly thought you knew. I mean, you must have known something.
I suppose you just didn't want to admit it. I think it's best if you do. It is over, your marriage.
Kenneth has been planning to leave you for months. It wasn't all my fault. I wasn't looking for anything. It just happened. There must have been something lacking.
Is that right? Listen! If you're trying to tell me that my husband and I have a crap sex life, then you're very much mistaken. If you're trying to say my husband told you we don't make it anymore, then you're a liar. Even if you knew who my husband was, he'd tell you how much he loved me and you're to get lost. All he needs, he gets it home. You don't have to worry about that.
He just doesn't fancy you anymore.
We have been married for nearly 20 years. Nobody fancies each other after 20 years, love. What the fuck is fancy? We make love because we love each other. Are you thinking of offering him a bit on the side? Flattering his ego? Try it, see what it gets you. Anyone can do that, doesn't make you special.
I'm special enough that he wants to leave you for me.
Leave me? You must be joking. You imagine this whole thing? Kenneth wouldn't go with you if you were the last woman alive. I know him. I'm married to him. I know his taste. He loves this house because you wouldn't know that thing if you never met him.
You'll get over it. I know you will.
Get out!
I'm sorry.
You're looking for trouble? You came to the right place. You're looking for trouble? Look right in my face. I was born stand up and talking back. How come?
No reason. I've just had a really great day.
What's for dinner? I'm starving.
Nothing.
I'll do you a salad.
Where's my album?
What album?
Me Aloha Hawaii album.
I don't know.
You don't know? Come on, you've been tidying things up all day. You must have moved it.
I haven't touched it, Kenneth.
Oh, bloody hell.
Did anything interesting happen to you today?
What do you mean, interesting? What sort of a question is that? What are you getting at with your interest?
Nothing. I just like to hear what you get up to.
What's get up to? Why would I get up to anything? It's work, it's a job. What's the matter with you?
Nothing's the matter with
me. You're always asking weird questions. Just get off me back.
Your album's in the bin.
What?
I trod on it. It cracked. I threw it in the bin.
For God's sake, woman, that's my best record!
You should have put it away!
What's wrong with you? Can't you even watch where you're putting your big feet?
Yes!
On top of everything else now, you're accident prone.
It wasn't an accident.
Well, you did it on purpose.
Yes!
What do you mean?
I trod on your stupid record on purpose.
You broke my record. On purpose?
I just said so, didn't I?
The people don't go around breaking my things for no reason!
I'm not people! I'm your wife and I had a very good reason.
Why?
I don't like it.
What?
Your record gets on my nerves.
You don't go around breaking my records because they get on your nerves!
I do.
Right, give me the money.
No.
Give us the money to buy a new one.
No, Kenneth.
You are completely mental. I can't believe I'm hearing this.
Why are you home so late from work?
Well, the traffic was bad. Why do you think? You break me best record. You haven't got me dinner on the table. You give me the third degree on what I've been doing every minute of the day. God knows why I'm mad at you.
I saw Laura today.
You That's all you care about. Can't you see what you've done? She'll never get over this. I'll have it on my conscience forever.
But she'll get over it.
Oh, what? Noah Well, do you? I live with her half my life. We were very happily married. There was nothing wrong with that man. His wife had to go and spoil everything.
You told me you wanted to leave here. You told me you wanted to get married again. You told me that marriage was over long before I met you, and now you tell me I've spoiled everything.
I wanted to tell her when the time was right.
The time was never gonna be right. You were lying to me and lying to her. It serves you right.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. I've just been thrown out of the house and I've got to listen to this.
Go and tell her you want her back then.
Well, I don't want her back.
Well, she knows, and that's that. It's better for everyone to be out in the open. Oh, I didn't ask for any of this. You called the shots. I've put up with it longer than most would, sitting on me own, waiting for you to phone, knowing you're with her. So don't you blame me, because it hasn't worked out just like you planned. I mean, if all you wanted was a bit on the side, you should have said. I would have contemplated it. Anyway, I think we should end this before anybody else gets hurt.
What? What? What are you saying? You're leaving? I can't believe I'm hearing this. I've just left my wife for you. And now you say you're leaving me?
Well, if it was such a good marriage, I wouldn't want to stand in your way. Obviously, your promises were empty.
Whoa. No, no, no. They weren't.
It's fine. Everything's gonna be great. I'm just a bit upset, that's all. 19 years. It's a long time.
So, how did she take it?
She was very upset.
She'll blame it on me.
Yeah. Still, she'll come round. You'll see.
Not good enough for him. Not hot enough for him. Not young enough for him. How dare he think he could dump me after all that conker I've done for him? I'll split open his head. I'll crack and I'll rip and tear and split. I'll crunch him and chop him and cut him up and then hang him to pieces. I'll slice his skin. I'll mince his flesh. I'll dissect and lacerate. I'll tear him limb from limb and then cut him up, the bastard. Bastard.
I've just come for the rest of myself, but if you're busy...
Well, you'd better come in.
Thanks very much. I'll only be a minute.
What's it like? Her place?
I'm staying with friends.
Liar! What's for you? My God, it must be something to throw all this away.
She makes me feel alive.
Lied?
when I was different.
Oh, you are a born liar, Kelly. But I told the truth when I said till death us do part. I meant it! You!
Hillary, put it away. You don't know what you're doing, you're upset.
I do. I'm gonna kill you!
This is so unlike you. You're so strong and together.
Oh, we were together, you and me!
We still can be! We still can be! I'll stop seeing her!
See how that night's come pouring out! Our whole life has been a lie!
I wanted to tell you, I meant to. I didn't want to hurt you.
Hurt me? Is that what you think?
Well, obviously you're a bit upset. I didn't want this to happen.
I bet you didn't. You wanted the best of both worlds. I know about men like you. I just didn't know you were wrong!
Hey, can't we just talk?
What about?
Anything you want. Tell me what to do.
Him? Why should I get you out of the little mess you're in?
I'll do whatever you say.
Because you're scared.
Because I love you. Because I love you.
Don't fall for it, dummy!
my husband, the man I married, a liar, a hypocrite, making up stories, fabricating evidence, inventing friends called Bob. How underhand can you get? What a shady, sanctimonious, smooth tongue snide, how insidious, how sly! Mr. Shifty, nice and nifty, left his wife approaching 50. Who'd have thought he'd have so much guile beneath that swindling, bogus smile, and me, outwitted, completely mystified by his trickery and collusion, months of confusion while all that time. Well, it all makes sense now. Now I see as clearly as the glass I like to smash over his head. It all falls very neatly into place. Horrible little man.
It's just so small, so squashed. I need to get out. I'm a big man. All these houses, exactly the same. Different curtains, same humdrum lives. It's boring, it's petty, it's tiny, and I'm suffocating. You are my escape route, my ticket to the top. With you, I'm a new man, with endless opportunities. Energy, optimism. I never thought I'd feel this way. I was beginning to think I'd been thrown on the tip, and it was time I retired to a life of memories and old times and look forward to dying, and it scares me. I mean, what's out there? Nobody knows. Well, I don't have to worry about it anymore. I can put it off for a good few years. I'm starting all over again, and I feel just like a teenager.
You know it's gone, 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 jumping like an echo. Yeah. You know it's gone, gone, gone.
How was she?
Oh, fine.
There, I told you everything would be all right. You worry too much.
I need something to eat.
Well, do yourself a sandwich.
Do myself a sandwich?
Yeah, why not?
Because I don't want a bloody sandwich. I want a decent meal. You're starving me to death.
Well, you know where the kitchen is.
Yeah, I know where it is. I just don't want to go there. You're going to be my wife, aren't you? Can't you even prepare a simple meal? Is that too much to ask?
You know I can't cook.
Well, of course you can cook. You're a bloody woman. Hillary was right. You're a good-for-nothing child. You're nothing but a spoiled brat. You're no match for her.
Well, get back there then if you miss her so much. And I don't give two shits what Hillary says about me just because she's bloody super wife. I'm not like that, so top shit!
Well, you might at least try.
On your bike, mate. Go on, out! I'm not going to look after you just so as you can shack up with somebody else when you need some excitement.
Well, maybe I made a mistake.
Yeah, maybe you did. And what are you going to do about it?
I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you. You can clear out. And you needn't bother coming back here unless you've got a big apology ready, right? And you can tell your ex-wife to mind her own business unless she wants me to go round there and tell her a few home truths. Tell her what her precious Kenneth thought of her for 19 years of marriage. How he suffered at the hands of a drudge and a nag and a frigid old bag. How would you like that?
You wouldn't dare.
Come on, don't kid yourself. I'm not frightened of it, or you.
All right, I'll do my own sandwich. Don't worry about the meals. I'll sort something out. Please don't go and talk to her. Hey, I don't want you getting upset.
I'm already upset.
you ever met her? She threw herself at you. That's what it was. Homewrecker. Marriage breaker. They're out there, all of them, swaying their hips and smiling their secret smiles. And you, Kenneth, now you're with her. Are you happy? Fulfilled? Do you live together and cry together and share together? Take footies of each other? Send cards and gifts and flowers? Big talk on the phone? Rush home from work to be together? Have hot baths and rampant sex? Late night drinks and breakfast in toweling rooms? His and hers, hers and his. So what if she can't cook? To hell with it! Eat out! Romantic restaurants, Chinese takeaway in front of the telly, chopsticks, not forks. And you spill some rice, and you giggle, and you leave it till morning, leaving time for the love and the lust and the fun and all the things you've decided matter now when I always used to.
It's not like that. She's got disgusting habits. She leaves her toenails to rot in the shag pile carpet. She picks her scabs. She swears. She hasn't got the same stature in the community. I really respect you, Hillary. I just love her.
Oh, well, that's all right then. I'll tell you where my stature in the community has got me. My good manners, my clean habits. Nowhere. Left alone. With nothing to show for years of trying to be a good wife.
Well, that kitchen has always been spotless. You should be proud of that. It's something to hold on to.
Oh, go on. Go to her. You lovely, dirty, smelly, sexy lover. Go on. Go and have deep throat sex and leave me to my sparkling kitchen.
Hey, I'll call around next week. Keep your chin up.
Hillary, once married to Kenneth, once attractive, then vicious, virile Hillary. Once wife, woman of the world, of the home being the world, Hillary, ex-wife, divorcee, disheveled, dishonorable. Hillary, how are you? You're looking well. Hillary, are you sleeping at nights, poor cow? Hillary, how is he? Do you ever see him? Hillary, what of her? How can you stand it? Hillary, where did you go wrong? Hillary, it's not your fault. Hillary, pull yourself together. Oh, Hillary, come out with this. Hillary, can I get you anything? Hillary, not cry again. Hillary, you'll be back. Hillary, forget him. Hillary, men, they're all the same. Hillary, Hillary, Hillary. When are you going to wake up? You're not the girl you were, so Kenny, today. He's looking younger, getting on with his life. I hear they're getting married. Are you going? What you need is another fella, someone to cheer you up. Oh, come on, Hillary, pull yourself together. It's all been over a long time ago. Can't you think of anything else? Piss off, Hillary, you're boring us to tears. You're not the only one, you know. So it was 19 years. It's in the past. You've got to look for the future. For God's sake, Hillary, he's not coming back. And even if he did, would you want him? He's not coming back. He's not coming back. You smug pig. I feel sorry for you, I do. Being the centre of attention, the focus for devotion, being cleaned for and cooked for, and when you've had enough of one, you start up with another, and look at you. Oh, with your hair thinning, and your jaw slacking, your belly potting and your gut belching, your arse farting and your feet stinking. I don't know who he thinks he's fooling, because he's not fooling me. You're spreading into middle age like a lump of lard gone soft. If I had any sense in my little head, you'd be out. Not two wives, but no wife, and too fucking old to score.
Hillary, shut up.
What's keeping her?
She doesn't just chuck things together like you, Laura. She'll be doing all the business.
Well, you know, it'll be time to go to bed by the time we eat.
Well, if you're bored, you can always go home.
You what?
Call a taxi. Go home.
And leave you here with your ex-wife?
Why not? What's wrong with that?
It's our bloody wedding anniversary.
All right, no need to raise your voice.
Dinner shouldn't be much longer. Any minute now.
Shall I put another record on?
Why not? Have a dance. After all, it's supposed to be a celebration. Go on, the two of you.
I don't feel like dancing.
Oh, well, come on then, Callum. You and me, for old time's sake. I don't suppose he's told you how we met.
No, I've never asked. Tower ballroom.
Remember? He looked at me from across the room, and my heart started beating as if for the first time.
I smiled at her and nodded. She smiled back. I offered to buy her a drink.
But I shook my head and indicated I'd had enough. He gestured, "Do you want to go?"
She said no. She had some friends with her, I think, so I said, "How about saving the last dance?"
And I thought, the last dance, yes! I'll save it for him!
So she nodded, okay.
And when they played Stardust Melody, we found each other in the crowd.
And I held her tight.
And I held him tight, and he looked handsome.
And she looked all right.
And we danced and kissed. All through the night. I think I'm gonna throw up.
Oh, not now, Laura, please.
It must be waiting for the food. I'll just pop in and check it. Won't be a move.
I don't want her food. I want us to leave.
I told you, it'd be rude to leave. And anyway, I'm starving.
You and your stomach, it's all you ever think about.
The kitchen is the murderer's paradise. Saucepans crack, knives chop, scissors stab, matches burn, microwaves electrocute, kettles are boiling, water scald, the possibilities are endless. Especially when you have an axe to grind. It's funny though, considering we spend most of the time in the kitchen, why it is male murderers often want to cook their victims. I'm surprised they know how. But me, oh, I'm an expert cook. I can disguise anything. Oh, Kenneth went to great lengths to encourage my interest in everything culinary. Well, naturally, husbands want their wives to be good and careful cooks. Their very health depends on it. But how foolishly they trust these men. How lacking in suspicion.
how many wives have pondered poison as they're stirred in the gravy? Or backing out at the last minute, just spatting it instead? It's food for thought though, isn't it? It's taken me a very long time to realise that even though I'm single and have been for many years, I'm still not free. I am suffering from the ex-wife syndrome. The bleak vision of the future has overtaken me. An image of myself, growing old, alone, not loving anyone ever again. I am plagued by fantasies of him, making love to her still, now. I am upset that he's looking good, been moving on in his life, because when I look at myself in the mirror, I see an image of a woman who doesn't measure up, one who has been banished to the sidelines and replaced. I see nothing more than Kenneth's ex-wife. Since the day he left me, obsessive thoughts have been slipping in and out of my mind. Shocking, morbid ideas. I was mincing some meat for my dinner, and I had a spark. What would it be like to mince him? Would he make a good steak? Or a better spaghetti bolognese? I mean, he's such a beefy man, and not just skin and bone. I mean, really meaty? Ooh. I can just smell the garlic on his breath. It's enough to frighten anyone to death. Frustrated, uncompromising, afraid of nothing but death, yet killing himself with tension, stress, greed, booze, and bloody-mindedness. We feed him, we create him, we allow him, and we have no one but ourselves to blame when we find ourselves stuck with him. He was married to her for a long time. He's bound to call a name out now and again when he's asleep. Or having sex. I don't mind that. I'll cook him something special. Surprise him. Get it just right. So tasty it will knock his socks off. He'll say, even Hillary couldn't have managed that. Delicious, he'll say, and smack his lips and ask for more. Bloody hell, seconds, that'd be a face. We'll crack open a bottle and we'll chink our glasses and he'll look at me all proud and full, stuffed and contented. He made the right choice. I'll even clean up the place. Well, you've got to work at your marriage if you want your marriage to work. I just can't seem to find the energy for things like that. But I'll cook him something edible if it's the last thing I do. Dinner won't be a minute, love.
Why is this place always such a tip?
I'm sorry, Ken. I'll do it again.
It's too late now. I'm home. I'm here. I want it done when I'm at work. I don't want you dusting around me while I'm trying to relax. What have you been doing all day?
I've been cooking.
Well, bloody day.
I
I've been shopping for it, preparing it. It's something special.
Well, I'm not hungry.
Not hungry, Ken? You must be. You haven't eaten.
I'm not in the mood for one of your efforts.
Oh, come on. You might at least try it. It's special.
If it's so bloody special, eat it yourself. I'm off somewhere I can get a decent meal. Not staying here with a slut of a wife who can't even lift a finger to pull her own weight.
I know where he's gone. I know what he's up to. He's sneaking back to her to get fed and all his washing done. I'll kill him. Well, I hope she's cooked him something really disgusting. I hope he chokes on it. I hope he tears it open and little insects scurry out. I hope a big fat slug is hiding in the lettuce. I hope it's infected with bacteria and he vomits in it. I hope it's past its sell-by date and is green with mould. I hope he hates it, hates it, hates! Where have you been?
I've been to see Bob.
Bob? Bob? Who's Bob?
Suspicion.
She does know. She does. I've been putting on weight. It's all those cream cakes you've been feeding me. Jesus Christ, I'm finished. How could she even suspect I've been so careful? Hey, you haven't been talking to her, have you? No, no, you wouldn't. It's just that I can't stand her cooking. It makes me feel sick to the stomach. I mean, you can understand that, can't you?
You're a big man. You need a good meal inside you.
Yes. Yes, exactly. Why can't she see that? All those burnt offerings, picking at charcoal, pretending it's yummy. I can't stand the farce. I need to be free. To eat big meals. Wholesome food. It's not that I'm greedy, just hungry. Well, starving. And her on this diet. It pains me to hear the calorie counting. Skimmed milk we drink, can you believe that? I need the thick, creamy, pasteurized kind. Grilled chips we eat! Whoever heard of a grilled chip? I need them sizzling in fat with chunky potatoes, white bread and butter, not crisp bread and sunflower margarine! It's obscene!
Sex life?
What?
Your sex life.
Oh, fine.
Ah!
She's nimble and tall. She's kept her figure.
Yeah, I suppose.
Well, you can't have it both ways, even. You must see that.
Why can't she be thin and me be fat? I mean, what's wrong with people? Why all this convention? We don't have to eat the same food.
It's too tempting for her to give you nice things.
Well, for God's sake, surely a bit of self-discipline might be in order. Or is that too much to ask?
It was too much for me.
So you got a bit porky. At least I was fed.
So why did you spend so much time in her bed?
I really didn't know I was capable of such thoughts. It's terrible, really, the way they creep up on you when you least expect them. Murderous thoughts. Cheap and nasty. If only Hillary would disappear. Ken couldn't find so much fault with me, no Hillary to compare me with. If only Hillary wasn't here, Ken would have to eat my meals. Without Hillary, we could be happy. It's just we're there still. Around, it makes that hard. A constant reminder of how good things were, how clean things were, how well cooked things were, how well ironed, how neat and how tidy. How I wish that Hillary would have an accident. Nothing really horrible, like a car crash, but maybe roll under something like a bus. must stop this soon. It leaves a nasty taste in your mouth. I mean, what's she ever done to me? Oh, I never thought I'd be like this over a man. I've always thought of myself as independent and free. It shouldn't matter what he thinks. I shouldn't let him rule my days. I'm sorry, God, for what I said about Hillary. She deserves a break. It's just, I don't think I can cope with life being such a useless wife.
Her hair is soft and her eyes are also blue. She's all the things a girl should be, but she's not you.
You haven't ironed me shirt properly.
Sorry. I'll do it again.
It's too late now. Shit time. Look at the time, Laura.
I don't know why we're going.
I've told you, it's rude to turn down invitations. You got no manners, that's your problem.
I thought we could go to the pictures or stay in.
What will we have to eat? Packets of popcorn or one of your messes?
You could take me out to eat.
I am taking you out to eat.
To a restaurant.
Why pay good money when you can get fabulous food for free? Anyway, you never eat anything.
That's not the point. It's more romantic.
Have you seen me cufflinks?
What cufflinks?
You know what cufflinks. I've only got one pair.
You're not wearing them.
Why not?
You know why not.
Give me the cufflinks, Laura.
No. You're just being insensitive. I'm not letting you wear something she gave you on our anniversary.
You are being childish.
I don't think so.
When are you going to start acting like a fully grown woman?
I don't like being a woman. I don't like it. I don't like being banished to the kitchen at parties, talking about stupid things with stupid females. I want to be where you are, with the men. Oh, laughing and joking and drinking and smoking. I want to join in. I can't do the things you ask of me. I'm not like your other wife. I'm not cut out for household chores. I cannot stand the monotonous, endless routines, the mindless activities involved. Who gives a fuck if the doorknobs aren't polished? Why make the bed just to sleep in it again? Can't see the point. Doesn't make sense. You do it if you want to. Hire someone. Hire Hillary! Anything just to get the pressure off my back! I do me best for you, don't I? It's not like I'm lazy or stupid or incompetent. I starve myself for you. I try and keep me fat bum down and me small tits up. I exercise! I know that I'm no great cordon bleu chef, but I have a go and the thanks I get! Have you any idea what it feels like to drool over cookbooks all day, fantasizing about delicious recipes that I'm not allowed to eat in case I get fat, and even if I could eat them, I couldn't fucking cook them for the life of me because I'm so crap! What happened to me? I was young and I was sexy. You wanted me. Now I'm a nervous wreck. What have I done? Where have I gone wrong?
You haven't gone wrong. I have. I should never have got a divorce. Hillary would never have behaved in that screaming, hysterical manner. You should be ashamed of yourself. Now, get a move on. We're going to be late for dinner. If you've got a cob on when we get there, there'll be trouble. Do you hear me?
Great you were. How wonderful. Yeah. It's hard to imagine he threw you away like a piece of dirt.
Shut your mouth or I'll kill you.
Do you hear that? He's gonna kill me. Yeah. Me, his wife, the woman he loves.
He didn't throw me away, actually. I threw him out of my house, even though he pleaded with me to stay. Is that right, Cody?
You got any more of them peanuts?
But I wish you'd let him stay.
Oh,
I wish you'd stayed together. I wish I'd never set eyes on either
of you. Don't listen to her. She doesn't know what she's saying. She's had too much to drink. Maybe if she had some food in her stomach.
Yeah. Oh, of course, you must both be famished. It is not of me keeping you waiting like this. I hope it's worth it. The famine before the feast.
Well, I'm sure it will be, but I mean, it must be ready now. I mean, what are you cooking? A slow casserole?
Kennedy, you'll spoil your appetite. Have an olive instead.
No thanks, I'll have another drink though.
And I will.
You will sit there and shut up!
Wait! Dinner is served.
Thank Christ for that.
Don't eat it, Ken. Don't stay here. Let's go home and I'll rustle you up some egg and chips. You know you like egg and chips.
Not yours, I don't.
Oh, come on. We'll go to bed. And we'll have some knocking instead of nosh.
You are turning my stomach.
But Ken, it's our anniversary. Please come home with me. I'm your wife now. Here it comes.
Fish for starters. Great.
Oh, watch for those that eat it slowly. The main course is nearly ready.
I've got to get somebody inside me. Help. Looks great. Just great.
Yes. Kenneth? Kenneth?
In husband murdering, yeah, of course.
Do you
think they'll hold us up as a disgrace to womankind?
Well, it's not the sort of thing we're meant to do, is it?
No. Do you think we're evil?
I don't feel evil.
Neither do I.
Perhaps we're mad.
They'll call us witches.
And burn us or duck us.
We're widows now.
Married, uncontrolled.
Yet even if they don't hang us, they'll find men to keep an eye on us.
Well, we'll have to get rid of the body.
Dispose of it. Lose it. Disappear it, leaving no trace.
How? He's a big man.
Not if we cut him off. We couldn't!
Then what do we do?
Turn on the oven! 400 degrees F! We can't!
Well, you'll have to do it. I'm a terrible cook.
Hey, what do we do with him after we've cooked him?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, he's yours, well, you saw him first. We'll have to eat him. I'm on a diet! It's the only safe way to dispose of the body. You eat them first, then you take a few laxatives. Either way, so long as he's flushed down the loo.
He'd kill us if he knew.
Well, he doesn't. So, you must be feeling a bit hungry for now.
Well, I suppose a little peckish. What were we having for dinner?
I told you. A surprise? Oh, yeah?